sugar for you.
There are my friends in Newcastle. This is Dr. Bucci for another segment of Dr. Bucci Reads. Still have on my special Albert Einstein shirt because I'm going to read you another story. We read previously, we did On a Beam of Light. This one is called Albert Einstein. Has a little bit different information about one of my favorite persons. This is about the life of Albert Einstein. And it was written by Jan Kent and illustrations by Isabel Munoz. My name is Albert Einstein, and I am a world-famous mathematician and physicist. Throughout my life, I asked and found the answers to many important questions. Join me on my journey of scientific discovery, which changed forever the way we think about energy, gravity, and the world around us. And there's this very special, very famous equation, E equals mc squared. I was born on March 14, 1879 in Rutenberg, Germany. My father, Hermann, was a salesman and engineer, and my mother, Pauline, ran the household. 2 years after me, my little sister, Maja, was born. We were a secular Jewish family. 6 weeks after my birth, my family moved to Munich, and my father founded Einstein & C. with his brother. It was a company that manufactured electrical equipment. I went to school at the Luitpold Gymnasium, where I discovered a lifelong passion for classical music and playing the violin. You see, we learned a little bit more about Einstein than we did in On a Beam of Light. In 1896, I applied to the Swiss Federal Polytechnic School in Zurich. I passed the entrance exam with flying colors and began training to become a teacher in physics and mathematics. But after getting my diploma, I struggled to find a teaching job. Instead, I acquired Swiss citizenship and in 1902 accepted a position as a clerk in the Swiss Patent Office. The following year, I married Milova Marek, a brilliant Serbian physics student I had met at school in Zurich, and with whom I already had a daughter. We went on to have 2 sons. During my stay at the Patent Office, I had time to explore more deeply some of my ideas, and I had during my studies at the Polytechnic. Okay, so we had a little bit more time on his hands. 1905 was to become one of the most important years of my career. During that time, I received my Doctor of Philosophy degree and had 4 papers published in the Annalen der Physik, one of the top physics journals at the time. 2 of the papers were on the photoelectric effect, and the other 2 were about my special theory of relativity. That cute little picture of him. To explain the relationship between matter and energy, I came up with an equation, E equals mc squared. Energy E of a body is equal to the mass, m, of that body, times the speed of light squared, c2. This discovery meant that tiny particles of matter could be converted into huge amounts of energy. See, that's where he came up with his special equation. Suddenly, I was in demand. In 1909, I was made an extraordinary professor at the University of Zurich. Then a couple of years later, I became professor of theoretical physics in Prague. I was appointed director of the Kaiser Wilhelm Physical Institute and professor at the University of Berlin in 1914. That same year, I became a German citizen again. I finally completed my general theory of relativity in November 1915. It was a culmination of my life's research. It meant we could more accurately predict planetary orbits around the sun and explained in greater detail than ever before how gravitational forces worked. Respected British astronomers Sir Frank Dyson and Sir Arthur Eddington took measurements and made observations during the 1919 solar eclipse. Their findings confirmed my theories, and from then on, I was famous in the world of science. So it took other scientists and folks to help prove Einstein's theories as correct. I won the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1921. It was for my explanation of the photoelectric effect, where I suggested that light is both a wave and a particle. This phenomenon is known as the wave-particle duality of light and has influenced the development of microscopes and solar cells. When particles of light, called photons, shine on a metal surface, they collide with electrons. The photons use some of their energy to knock the electrons loose. The rest of the photon's energy is then transferred to the now free-roaming negative charge, and they are called photoelectrons. Pretty cool. I immigrated to America from Berlin in 1933. I was unhappy with the rise of the Nazi movement, so I gave up my German citizenship for political reasons. I became a United States citizen in 1940. I lived in Princeton Township, where I was a professor of theoretical physics at Princeton University. The university was an outstanding center for the study of theoretical physics. I worked here until I retired in 1945. After World War II, I took a leading role in the world movement. I was passionately committed to the cause of global peace, believing that patriotism was often used as an excuse for violence. I considered myself a citizen of the world, and so I endorsed the League of Nations, followed by its successor, the United Nations. So Albert liked peace. He didn't want his findings and his thoughts to be used for bad things. Throughout my life, I spent a lot of time on my own, pondering and planning. When I did have a spare moment to relax, music really helped put my busy mind at ease. It also influenced my science work, which I wanted to become harmonious with a sense of beauty. There's his violin. I had participated in brain studies throughout my life and wanted my brain to be preserved after my death so that in the future it could be studied by doctors of neuroscience. Thomas Stoltz Harvey did as I wished, and my brain is now located at the Princeton University Medical Center. In 1999, when Canadian scientists were studying my brain, they found that my inferior parietal lobe is 15% wider than in most people. This part of the brain processes spatial relationships, 3D visualizations, and mathematical thought, and researchers believe it explains why I was so intelligent. Really cool. My greatest achievements have changed the way scientists of today think and how they approach their work. Every time I made an astonishing discovery, I used it as a stepping stone for the next one. Have determination, never stop questioning, and finding answers. So that was pretty good advice. Never stop questioning, be determined, and always go after finding your answers. And that's another story about my favorite scientist, mathematician, theoretical physicist, Albert Einstein. Until next time, remember, be safe and always be kind. See ya.